So let's come to standing in the middle of our mats. Once again, tuning into our alignment, having the feet hip width apart, and maybe having the outer edges of the feet parallel, so it might feel slightly pigeon-toed. Becoming aware of the alignment of the hips over the ankles. Becoming aware once more of the tanden, or dantian, the energetic center of the body, 3 fingers width, below the navel. As though there's a weight drawing the tailbone down, which corrects any tipping of the pelvic bowl. So we can imagine the pelvic bowl like a bowl of water that we don't want to either tip forwards or backwards. Arms alongside the body, fingers drawn down by gravity, a little bit of space underneath the armpits. The crown of the head lifting skyward as though we're hanging from a thread. Lifting the toes and becoming aware of that bubbling spring point, which is at the meeting of the second and third toes in the sole of the foot, about 1/3 down, the body of the foot, not including the toes. And this point corresponds roughly with, in the Hatha tradition, Padabandha, the footlock, which keeps the energy rising up. Spreading the toes wide, especially that little toe into which the bladder line ends, and placing them back down. Maintaining that sense of groundedness and lifting. We're just going to take a few breaths here with the arms, because it's been windy and we're just going to have a little bit of grounding work. So on the next inhalation, we're going to take the arms wide, inhaling and extending the fingers to the farthest reaches of the universe. Inhaling, gathering in all the energy into a ball, harvesting it. And then as we exhale, drawing it down through the body, down through the trunk and into the legs, back down into the earth. One more like that. Inhaling as you extend with your own breath in your own time, reaching and gathering in the energy that has been swirling around, stormy energy maybe, drawing down, calming, centering and grounding into the legs. One more like that. Inhale. Extending out into the far reaches of the universe, scooping and gathering and harvesting the energy, drawing down. And feeling more grounded there. Okay, we're going to come onto all fours. So to take a little bit of work with the lower back as requested. So checking in with your alignment. I'll come sideways just so that you can see. We want the wrists directly under the shoulders, knees directly underneath the hips. And we're just going to work with what's traditionally known as the cat-cow posture. So, becoming aware of the tailbone, as we exhale, we're going to drop the tailbone down and drop the crown of the head, lift the tummy button, lift the pelvic floor, Mula Bandha in the Vedic terms. And as we need to inhale, tilting the pelvis the other way, dropping the navel, you can tuck the toes under to extend the pelvic tilt and lengthening through the upper body. Exhaling. Dropping the tailbone, dropping the crown of the head and lifting up the navel and the tanden. Inhaling, coming the other way. And just working with your own breath in your own time. And the movement is led by the tailbone, so you feel this wave of movement through the spine. Inhaling, just working with your own breath in your own time. And it's the breath that dictates the pace of the movement. So use the breath to fully exhale and empty the lungs. And then you'll notice that you need to inhale, and that's driving the movement in the other direction, led by the tailbone. So we're experiencing a wave of movement through the spine. Just a couple more breaths like that, fully experiencing the movement from the tailbone to the crown of the head, squeezing all the stale air out. Inhaling fresh breath when you need to. And then just coming back into a neutral spine. And if you feel like it, if you want to close your eyes, then please do, but just however you do this, just turn your attention inwards and you can just start to make any movements that your body is inviting you to make. So listening to the body. Moving spontaneously as your body tells you it needs to move. So you might need to twist, you might need to shake, you might need to jiggle, you might need to wriggle, or maybe you need nothing at all. Taking your time to explore into any tight bits, any crunchy bits, shaking or wriggling, jiggling out any tension that's been hiding in there. Good. Want to turn the wrists around or anything. Anything goes, really. Okay. And when we're feeling ready, we're going to come back into a child pose. So take child pose of your choice. If you want to separate the knees, please do. Otherwise, you can take the classic version, arms extended out front. Or you can make what's quite nice, a little pillow for your forehead. Or something I've been working with, which I quite like, is two fists, one on top of the other, like those potato fists that we used to have in the playground. You can rest the forehead there. Or if you want to release a little bit more in the shoulders, you can bring the hands around to the back of the body towards the soles of the feet. Good. Becoming aware of that tanden, seed of potential within us. Good. Okay, let's all together bring the arms out in front. Now we're going to start to move forwards between these hands. Between the hands, we're going to start to snake forwards. So weight coming into the hands, then coming into the elbows. It's quite strong, so go slowly, moving the weight, shifting the weight into the hands and snaking forwards as you do so, coming up into a nice gentle back bend. So now be really mindful, especially if you have lower back issues. You could just take, maybe tuck the tailbone under a little, lift the pelvic floor and lift the navel back And we've got the extension happening more in the upper back. There's the sensation that the hands are pulling back and the heart's opening forwards. The neck is long. And we're quite active in the upper back. Couple more breaths here. Good. We're lowering the head back down, forehead down, hands under the shoulders. We're going to tuck the toes, and maybe you can come straight up, or maybe you come onto the knees. We're going to come up into a down facing dog. So lifting the hips up towards the sky. And we've got the sensation spreading the fingers wide. We've got the sensation of the sit bones lifting up to the sky. External rotation of the shoulders. So we've got the creases of the elbows starting to move towards the front of the room. Couple more breaths if you can. If not, please come back down into child. And now we're all going to move into child. So bringing the knees forward, bringing the tailbone back to the heels. And we're not going to stay here. We're going to move forwards a bit again. Once more through those arms, snaking forward, keeping low to the ground. And then coming up, now you can stay, come up back up into Sphinx if you're feeling a little bit more adventurous and want to come up into a cobra with the hands underneath the shoulders, elbows facing backwards, but just be really mindful, as always, of your lower back. So tuck, you can tuck the tail under, lift the pelvic floor, lift the navel up and back, allow the shoulders to move backwards and the heart to lift forwards. Of course, you've still got the option of staying on your elbows. Good. Okay, lowering back down once more. Head down, hands under the shoulders. Let's lift the hips once more. Or if this is too strong for you, please feel free to stay in a child pose. And options here. So you can come back down onto your knees as we did before and snake forwards, or say you're feeling a little bit more energetic, you could start to swoop down through the hands. It's coming straight down and up into a back bend of your choice. So it can be, we can be going now for up dog, or cobra, or sphinx. So all of the options available there. Whichever back bend you're taking, just be mindful again of the lower back and the opening happening up in the upper back. Couple more breaths if you can. Good. And lowering the head back down. Tucking the toes once more. Lifting into a downward facing dog. And we'll drop the knees back down gently, just gently. We'll lower the knees down, not drop them. Lower them down. Come back into a child. We'll just do one more thing, I think, working through this, the front and back planes of the body, the kidney lines and the bladder lines. So coming back onto all fours. We're going to step forward with the left foot. So bringing the left foot forward, and then taking the back knee back or the front foot forward as much as you can, so that we're in this really deep lunge. I'll show you sideways. And if you've got any issues with your knee, of course you can fold the mat over or place some sort of support underneath it, cushion or blanket. Just bringing the hands to the front knee. And we're just going to start to extend through the hands. So just gently opening up through the front body. Lengthening through the front plane. If you want to go a little bit further, you could bring the arms in so that they're sort of reaching behind you. But all the while we're dropping into it. Couple more breaths here if you can. Good. Okay, as we exhale, bringing the hands down, we're going to shift the weight now onto the back knee. So the hips are over the back knee, and just check that the front knee and it's not, the hips aren't coming into a diagonal with the front leg. So just check that that back hip is being, the hip of the front leg is being pulled back into the socket, so we're square. You can come onto your finger pads if that feels okay. Inhale to lengthen through the heart, and exhale as we fold forwards over that front leg. So just as far as feels good. If you want to experience a little bit more sensation in the back of the body, you can lift the front toes so they start to move towards you. And just remembering you can experience that bladder line once more, running from the insides of the eyes, looping over the scalp down either sides of the spine, backs of the legs until the outside little toe. Dropping the head. Couple more breaths if you can. Just breathing into any tight spaces. Good. Slowly starting to come forward. Hands either side of the feet. We'll tuck the toes of the back foot under and step back into a downward facing dog. And we might notice the difference between one side and the other side. So stepping forward this time with the right foot and laying the back knee down as wide as we can go. So again, if you need to take some support underneath your knee, please feel free. Hands to the front. Let's have a different hand on top this time so it feels a little bit weird. Pressing into the hands, lengthening the arms. Again, being mindful of the lower back. So lift the pelvic floor, lift the navel up and back. And then we can bring the arms in if that feels, only if that feels good. Lengthening through the front line of the body this time. Good. Okay. Exhaling, we're going to bring the hands back down and shifting the weight onto the back knee once more, checking the alignment of the hips. We want them square to the front. And don't feel that this front leg has to be straight. If it needs to bend, that's absolutely fine. Inhaling to lengthen. Exhaling to hinge forward from the hips over the front leg. Again, you've got the option to flip the toes towards you if you want to feel a little more into the back line of the body. Dropping the head so that we can explore that whole energy channel once more on this side. The bladder line, corners of the eyes, looping through the scalp, down the sides of the spine, into the glutes, backs of the legs, hamstrings. Outside little toe. Just scanning through, noticing anywhere you can bring your awareness to loosen up, let go. Good. Okay, let's start to shift the weight forwards. And stepping, tucking the toes under and stepping back into a downward facing dog. And hopefully we're feeling a little bit more evened up now on both sides. We're going to step forward with the feet either side of the hands, outsides of the hands, by way of transitioning into a squat. Now, if the heels come up, absolutely fine. We're not really going to stay here for very long anyway. It's just by way of moving down onto our backs. So gently lowering the buttocks if you can, but use your hands to support if you need. Usually I come thumping down like an elephant at the end. And from here, making our way onto our backs, nice and mindfully, we're just going to lower down, nice and slowly. Lovely. Let's extend the legs away if you need to, if you want to. Otherwise, you can have the knees pointing up. Hands either side of the body or resting on the belly. Relaxing all your efforts now. And allowing your awareness to be spontaneously drawn to any sensations in the body. And just observing and experiencing them without analyzing or placing meaning or wishing it was any different. Awareness of sensations in parts of the body and in the whole body. Experiencing parts of the body and the whole body at the same time. Experiencing aliveness and joy in parts of the body and in the whole body. Starting to deepen the breath and bringing some movements into the fingers and into the toes. And on your next inhalation, taking the arms up overhead, reaching away with the fingers and the toes and filling the lungs to capacity. And as you exhale, rolling over onto your right hand side, resting there for a couple of breaths.
And when you're feeling completely ready, coming up into comfortable sitting position. Thank you.
I think I should put the cat on. Yeah.
Yes.